everyone, welcome to Magic TV. I am Tristan Shaun Gregson, and it's been way too long.
It's been
finally
a while.
Back here with Brad Nelson. What do you think of the new scheme?
I like it. This is not Humphrey, though.
It's Humphrey? It's indestructible Humphrey, because Humphrey, he had a drinking problem. And that problem was he couldn't get enough of it, and he eventually hit the trash. But we have Darksteel Humphrey, who has...
I mean, you can't really give a plant a different name, like the same name, right? It's a different plant.
Wow, apparently you're not Brad Nelson Jr.
Because it could be Humphrey Jr.
I don't know. That seems weird. It's Darksteel Humphrey. He's
it's
been
Darksteel
named.
Darksteel Humphrey. Okay. Darksteel All right. Humphrey.
All right. See, you've been way too long. You could have had input on this. You could have had a decision, but... All right. So, let's be real here. A year ago, we sat here on the verge of worlds. You were in a very different spot.
I was.
You still get to play some sweet magic. You get to play with the guys out there still very jealous of you. Wish that you could sit in this chair. I could go back to my draft. But, I mean... You know, doesn't have to go into depth. What happened? What's the difference between Brad Nelson a year ago and Brad Nelson right now?
The big difference between last year and this year was one thing about last year is I thought I was like really, really, really good at Magic, which I'm fine. You know, I'm not on the level of like Luis or Paulo or anything, but like I ran really good last year. Like if you look at through a lot of my results, like two of my top eights were on tiebreakers. One was with the DQ, and it was playing a lot better. For some reason, like, confidence is this big thing that I learned about this year that I didn't really know much about last year, is the ball goes both ways. Like, last year, I was winning a lot, making really good decisions, trusting my instincts, and going from there. And the better I played, the better I would continue to play. And that happened throughout all year until about Worlds. I don't know if Worlds was this, like, back-breaking experience for me, but I did terrible in both events. I did terrible in Worlds, and I did terrible in the Magic Online Championships. I don't know if I was playing poorly, but I wasn't playing on the same level I was before. And I spent a lot of time through this last year, like, I didn't stop playing Magic. I probably played 75 to 80% as much Magic preparing for events, where I'd still grind, you know, hundreds of hours on Modo, but just not, you know, 200 or something like that. And my play went down, and I didn't really understand why. I kept making small mistakes, and they weren't like punts. They weren't like, oh, I forgot those in my graveyard or something like that. It was like theoretical like mistakes. Like I would see the board and I would come to a conclusion it was wrong. And that never happened last year. And that ball just kept rolling. And like this year I'm having a really difficult time like understanding like my own plays. Like I'm not trusting my judgment. I'm not trusting anything about myself when I play and I keep making more mistakes. And I think that's coming around, but not on the same level. Like, it's like this big like elephant in the room that is really giving me trouble. That it still happens today. Like, I'm still playing a ton of Magic. I'm trying to get back to just grinding and just being completely technical. Because last year I was really high in the technical level, but I was also really good on the theory, and that's just not there right now. So I'm trying. Like, I've done like 120 drafts in this format, and I'm starting to really learn that and playing a ton of Magic with, you know, the team. So I'm hoping it comes around here soon.
I mean, I don't think Magic has outgamed Brad Nelson. I don't think, like, you know, it's, you know, people come up with different theories. Like, well, he just isn't playing as much anymore. Yeah. Or, like, he just got lucky. And, you know, again, it's a combination of things. And as you mentioned, like, you know, you top-eighted an event on DQs. You ran really well. And again, it snowballs. And it's hard because there are so many events, there's so much you have to keep playing, and I mean, with you, like, even the SCG events, like, you could go to them, you could commentate them, like, that's more weekends, more time you're taking up. It's hard to slow yourself, I would imagine it's hard to slow yourself down and be like, okay, well, like, let's really stop, break these things down, like, let's look at my play.
Yep.
And, you know, for me, like, I definitely understand just, you know, being Luis's counterpart, to have to go to events and be like, well, this is, like, my one PTQ I get to play all season. Like, if I don't win this thing... Like, what happened to me? Like, I'm supposed to know anything about this game, and I have one shot. Like, and for you, that's that to the extreme. Like, every single event you sit down, even any match. And I remember talking to you last year. It was like, you know, just take it round by round, take it game by game. Like, you break it down decision by decision. And sure, everything kept coming up Brad, but that wasn't, you know, that wasn't luck. Like, you had everything going for you, and you made it work. Do you, you know, I'm glad to hear you are still wanting to play as much as you are, if not go more. I mean, one of the questions I thought about when stopping to ask you was like, well, do you want to take, you know, some months off to restructure your game? Do you want to just go back to Moto grinding all that time that you did before? Is that where, you know, you lose it? And I'm sure these are questions you've all asked yourself. So I really
multiple times.
Yeah, I just, you know, I really wanted to just sit you down and be like, you know, I still think you're great. I still think you're great at this game. Obviously, everybody out there still thinks that, you know, the FF freak is good enough to be part of this test team.
I mean, one of the things is, like, people have rough years, and I'm not using that as an excuse. Like, but, like, the variance between doing well and doing bad, like, happens. And one of the things that I learned from Ben Stark that was, you know, it was a brilliant piece of logic, was the difference between winning and losing in Magic is... there's not much of a difference, actually. Like, you play your best abilities, like, the game's very high variance, and sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Sometimes that's based on luck, most of the time it's based on skill. But that was, like, really interesting. It was, like, at a time I needed it a couple months ago. Because, like, I mean, I feel like I'm starting, at the beginning of the season, I played pretty poorly. But, like, I'm starting to come around, but the tournaments just aren't coming together. Like, I'm always... 2 wins away from, you know, big pro points or, you know, cash.
You were top 16 at recent GP, or was
that was earlier this season in Texas, somewhere in Texas. But like this last pro tour, I lost my last 2 rounds or I would have top 16, and that was a little frustrating. But I seem to, like, be in that cusp, and I've only day two'd like half of my events this year. So, I mean... It's rough. It's something that I know about, but I'm willing to admit that, you know, like, I am not this invincible creature that sprouted up in Magic.
You know, I wish Ben was here right now, because his wisdom is very zen-like. I mean, yes. We sat in Philly and talked at length, I think the night we went to dinner, and even after that, just about...
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's this game, there are still very small margins.
Mm-hmm.
And to be the best you could possibly be and to continue to play at the very height you possibly can is only going to increase that just a little bit. I mean... He's very humble when to talk about his win in Paris and the things that had to go right there. Yeah. And, you know, sure, one of the hardest things is just making sure you stay at that level and you play consistently there.
Yep.
And for you, to me, it's just like, you know, just find a stride again.
Oh, yeah. I mean, one thing that I think could be, like, hurting me a little bit is last year, all there was winning or losing. You know, that was it. Like, that was the mindset. Like, there wasn't a loss. Like, if a loss was, like, you know, death. You know, that's how my mindset was. But one thing about this year is, like, I really, really love doing, like, SCG opens. I'm starting to get a little bit more of a feel to do that kind of stuff. And, like, I even want to, like, take over the Magic show. Like, I want to take that over from everyone. He, like, canceled it. And I know it's, like, this, like, sad part, because I was a huge fan of the show. Like,
same here.
I got to do an intro when I was in Honolulu, and, like, me and my brother were jumping up and down at home. But, you know.
So if you go back to that moto grinding, it's real easy. You know, turn the camera one way, record the draft, turn the actual camera the other way, record the show. Like, I think this is something you could set up.
I mean, could happen. I mean, I'd like a camera guy, you know, maybe Butler.
They're hard
to
come by. Maybe we could. And they're not the nicest people either. They always find a way to get you when you're scratching your ass or something. Like, every single day. Like, gosh, why did I wear that? But you'll have creative control over these things, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Unlike,
I mean,
some of us.
Yeah, if that ended up happening. But, like, I love doing, like, that kind of stuff. And that probably hurts me a little bit, because, like, last year it was just life or death.
I mean, how many times did you finish just on the outside last year? Like, so close to top 16, not quite, or even top 32? That's something that I don't think really people stop to think about.
No, like, last year I top 8 at over 50% of the events I played in.
And how many GPs did you not day 2 last year?
All of them that I didn't top 8.
That is a crazy stat. You know, who really stops to think about that?
Yeah.
And that, again, that's such a unique circumstance that...
Mm-hmm.
You know, who else could you really talk to compare to this? It's like, did you ever have a year where, you know, either when you went all the way, you went super deep in this tournament, or you just, you know, you got two days off in a city?
To be fair, it like the limited ones came down to me always knowing the limited formats, and if I had a pool that could get me through to day two, I, like, drafted and just, you know, ran the tables. Like last year, I 2-1 or 3-0'd almost all of my draft pods, like tons of times. Like 2 pro tours, I 6-0'd, which is really important. And then it just, like, Nashville hit, where I had a terrible pool, you know, and then it just all snowballed since then. But, like, one of the big things that, like, I've learned through having this experience of, like, you know, being on, you know, BDM's article every single week, I think there's, like, 3 in a row where I was, like, one of the highlighted, because it was, like, Player of the Year, Magic Online thing, and something else, like, and being all over the spotlight to, you know, just making level 4 this year, like, the big thing about that is like to not really put as much stock into success with the game because you want it and it feeds you. But the most important thing is to just try to play the best game, because like that's what I'm concerned about right now, because I'm not playing the best game I have. I'm not really concerned about like not making the top eights, even though like, you know, it was something that I did all the time. Like you should feel like you have a hunger for that, but it's not. It's like, I always look back at tournaments and I'm not, you know, sad that I'm not in Owen's position like he is this year. I'm sad that I made a mistake, you know, in round seven that cost me, you know, a match where I wouldn't have had that. And that's like the big concern. So like, just like I was last year, I'm just concerned about like the moment and making the correct plays and taking down the game that you're in. Because if you let anything else happen, you know, it hurts. And like, that's the demon I have, is that I'm really set on not understanding my plays, and like I'm letting my like focus, you know, change that because I'm thinking about all the mistakes that I'm making, and that's just a complete snowball. It's just the psychological warfare that I'm dealing with. Like, I still think I'm really good at the game. Like, I do like a lot of the lines I make, and you know, on Moto, like I'm still winning a lot of my drafts and playing a bunch of constructed and fueling that, you know, addiction. But I don't know. It's just the big events this year have been pretty rough.
Again, it reminds me of the Ben Stark. You have to get to that kind of like, yep, that Zen type feeling where it's like, you know, I'm going to go out, I'm going to make sure I make these decisions right. Yeah. Like, I'm going to get my margins. Like, it just reminds me, again, we went to dinner in Philly and Paulo and Ben both did not day two. And mm-hmm. they were, it was like, you know, one was carrying a conversation about how he didn't and pro points and all these things. And mm-hmm. the other one was just kind of like, you know, oh, this food's good.
Yeah.
And
like, fondue is amazing.
Ben, to me, is kind of that perfect example of like, you know, he's gonna go, and if he doesn't make day two, you know, he's gonna go to the next event. He's mm-hmm. gonna get there and like eventually win a pro tour. And I think that you're gonna be able to get back there. Like,
oh yeah, I mean,
I don't want to like, you know, make any kind of terrible premonitions or anything, but I imagine you're gonna win another pro tour in your lifetime.
I've never won one yet.
Wow, that was bad.
Yeah.
So close.
I was close.
So
I
close.
Mean, that's the most important match to play. Like, I'd of course want to win it, but like, playing the last match of a tournament is always the best feeling. Like, that's just, you know, it's all on the line, two people, it's like the Coliseum. Like, I loved playing that match against Paul. Like, I wish we would have went further than three games, but like, I mean, that's why we play it. Like, it was the experience and it was a ton of fun. And like, I think I'm probably going to end up like, you know, hopefully I would hope that I do well in another event. I mean, I'm assuming I will.
I think to me it's just a matter of time, and you know, I'm not going to say like, you know, 2 weeks from now, 1 week, this weekend,
today. You guys have an FNM, right?
It's I think like Tuesday or something. I mean, by the time this goes up, it could be. You could be winning FNM.
Let's just have it go up Friday, and then
sure, perfect, done. Thanks for watching.